Hello friends, welcome back in my YouTube channel. And today I'm going to start with a new series. It's a random series. It based on certain requirements. And today I'm going to start with tutorials on Oracle Ref Cursor, the most important topic related with the projects and all. And today I'm going to discuss with Ref Cursor, a strong Ref Cursor, weak Ref Cursor. So let me start with the Oracle first. Remember, this particular topic is related with PL/SQL in Oracle. And to get the better understanding of this Ref Cursor, initially you should get the knowledge of the cursor, you should get the knowledge of Oracle packages, Oracle procedure, and after that you will get the complete advantage of this Ref Cursor. But now I am going to start with the Ref Cursor first of all. So what exactly the Ref Cursor is, that we need to understand. Ref stands for reference, means reference cursor we are talking about. Normally in Oracle we use out mode in the stored procedure. The out mode is basically used to return the value. In Oracle even the procedure can return the value. To return the value we have to use the out mode in Oracle. But the thing is that by the use of out mode, you can maximum return one value. What I'm looking for, I'm looking for the complete table. I want to create a stored procedure that will return the complete table, like select a star from EMP. So what I'm looking for, I'm looking for the Ref Cursor. So I'm just going to start with Oracle, connect /Scott/Tiger. And this is my table. Its EMP table is there. Now what I am looking for, I want to create a procedure that will return the entire table. So let me start with the, I am just going to write ed. Ed stands for edit. This is the way to write the PL/SQL program. I am writing ed:// I am just going to create a file. So Ref Cursor is what? It's a reference cursor. Reference cursor. For your kind information, what exactly the cursor is? When we are talking about the cursor, cursor means memory. Remember, when we execute any SQL statement in Oracle, when we execute any SQL statement in PL/SQL, Oracle allocates memory for that. And that memory is known as cursor. When we execute any SQL statement in PL/SQL, Oracle allocate memory for that. And that memory is known as cursor. Suppose I need to execute select a star from EMP. Within the PL/SQL. For this, what exactly we required? We required the cursor. To get the detailed knowledge about the cursor, you need to wait for my next video that will be based on the cursor. But right now, what I'm going to start with, Ref Cursor. So Ref Cursor means what? It's a reference cursor. Why we use Ref Cursor? Suppose if you want to return, if you want that procedure should return, the entire table. Using out mode. If you want that procedure should return, the entire table using the out mode, we have to use the Ref Cursor. Basically, it will return the reference. It will return the address. So you can consider it as pointer also. So in Oracle, for the pointer and all, what we are having? We are having the Ref Cursor. So now I am going to create the example. To create the Ref Cursor, at first I am going to create the package, create or replace package. Suppose my package is X is, now I am going to create the cursor like type T is ref cursor. Type T is ref cursor. So I am just going to declare the variable T is of type ref cursor. So ref cursor is basically what? It's a kind of data type over here. Now I am going to use procedure get emp, and now I am going to use y, outmode variable is there, and just I am going to use t. So what will be the type of this y? It will be type of ref cursor t, and we are using outmode. Outmode means what? The procedure will return the value. Now I am going to make it end. So this is my package specification. Now what I am going to do, I need to create the body for this. So I am just going to write create or replace package body, and we don't need to declare this. Procedure get emp y out of t is begin. We just need to use open y for select star from emp end. Now what I am going to do, file, save, just going to close this. Now I am going to compile it at the rate e colon slash pl1.sql. Package created, package body created. So our ref cursor get created. Now what I need to do, I need to execute the stored procedure over there. So just I need to declare the variables where z is of type ref cursor. So it will return the value in z. Just wait, I am writing ed t colon slash pl1.sql. My package name is x and my stored procedure name is get emp, that we need to remember. Okay, I am going to declare the variable is of type var z is of type ref cursor. Remember, when we use the ref cursor keyword in PL SQL, we need to give the spaces over there. But when we use ref cursor in the SQL environment, in SQL star plus environment, we need to remove the space from here. So z is what? It's a kind of variable is of type ref cursor. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to write execute. The package name was x, and within the x package there was a procedure called get emp, and I need to pass the parameters for that. I'm going to pass the parameter colon z. So this is how we can call the out mode. Now the value is there with the z. How we can display this? I am just writing print z and we are getting the detail. So this is what, this is the concept of ref cursor. In this particular variable means this stored procedure is going to return the entire table, and that's why we are getting like print z and we are getting these things. So this was the first example related with the ref cursor. Once again I am going to open this file. So this is what, this is your ref cursor. A ref cursor means the stored procedure is going to return the entire table. Now, in the place of writing these example like this, what we can do? What we can do? This is the group comment. Once again, I am going to copy it. In the place of like we are using type T is ref cursor. From Oracle 9i, we don't need to declare this ref cursor like this, so we can just ignore this. And what we can use, we are writing procedure y is of type out, and we can use sys underscore ref cursor. So this is the new type declared, we can declare over here, and this particular type get introduced in Oracle 9i. So this is what, this is sys underscore ref cursor, used to declare the ref cursor, used to declare the ref cursor. So just in the previous example, and this was the new feature in Oracle 9i, earlier it was not there. And so what we need to do, we don't need to write the type T is ref cursor. So what we need to do, just we need to write procedure get emp, y out mode will be there, and in the place of this T and all, we are just using sys underscore ref cursor. the same variable, same data type we need to use over here. Everything will be the same, only the thing is that we don't need to declare this variable now. Run this. So this is the example. This is the example of sys underscore ref cursor. Close this, and I'm going to use, again I'm going to declare the variable var t is of type ref cursor. Now I'm going to use execute. What was the name of the package? It's x. What was the name of the procedure? It's get emp. And I'm just going to give the value like colon t. Now print t and you will get the answer. So this is the second way to write the ref cursor. So initial, the normal example of ref cursor was there. In the second example, we are just using, in the second example, we are just using sys underscore ref cursor. Now, the third thing regarding the ref cursor. Once again, I am just going to make the comment for this. All these notes will be available on my particular blog. I will give you the URL of that particular blog. Now, once again, I am going to use, see, there is different types of ref cursor is there. Types of ref cursor. Types of a ref cursor. There is two type of ref cursor. One is a strong ref cursor. One is a strong ref cursor. A strong ref cursor means what? It will return, when the return will be there, when the return type will be there, is known as a strong ref cursor. And the second one is, we are having the weak ref cursor. We are having the weak ref cursor. Weak ref cursor means what? When the return type, when we don't have any return type, we don't have any return type. If so, I am not going to use any return type over there. It will be the example of weak ref cursor. And when we are going to give the return type, it will be the example of a strong ref cursor. So now I am going to create the example for the weak ref cursor. The earlier example, the previous examples are the example of weak ref cursor. How? Suppose I am going to use this program only. I am going to write create or replace. Here we are declaring the ref cursor and we are not mentioning any return type. So this is what? This is the example of weak ref cursor, and you can execute this example, that's not a problem. Now the second one is what? And suppose if I need to create a strong ref cursor, in that case what we need to do? This is the example of a strong ref cursor. Strong ref cursor. In a strong ref cursor, we need to mention the return type. So I am using type t is ref cursor return emp percentage row type. If I am going to use return type with the cursor, ref cursor is known as a strong ref cursor. In a strong ref cursor, why it is called a strong? Because everything is defined at the compile time. We are defining like this ref cursor will contain the address of this particular type in percentage row type. So what is the difference between a strong ref cursor and weak ref cursor? The first difference is, here we don't need to declare, here we don't need to use the return type. That's why it is weak cursor. But the advantage is, in the place of select star from EMP, we can give like select star from department, it's fine. But for the strong ref cursor, if we are using return type is equal to in percentage row type, so every time we need to use select star from EMP. Means the same structure should be there. The table can be different, but the structure should be same. So this is the important thing, we have to use return type. And this is what, this is your strong ref cursor. Now I am going to execute this. At the rate, package created, I am going to declare the variables. Var t is of type ref cursor. Now I am going to execute this. Execute. Package name is x and procedure name is getEMP, and it's going to return the value in t. Now apply print t and we are getting this. So this is what, this is the example of a strong ref cursor, weak ref cursor, this is what, this is the example of strong ref cursor and weak ref cursor. And for your kind information, this is the good piece of interview questions for you. Like, what is the difference between a strong ref cursor and weak ref cursor? What we can say, in a strong ref cursor, always we need to use the return type. But in the weak ref cursor, we don't need to use the return type. If return type is not there, that particular cursor defined as weak ref cursor. If return type is there, that particular cursor is defined as the strong ref cursor. And remember, performance wise, a strong ref cursor having the advantage over the weak ref cursor. Because in weak ref cursor, we are not going to declare the type. So, performance wise, it will take time. But the strong ref cursor, you are going to declare each and everything at the compile time itself. So performance wise, a strong ref cursor will be better than in compared to weak ref cursor. So this is all about the cursor, ref cursor mainly. So why we use the ref cursor? Ref cursor means reference cursor. What is the purpose of this? If we want that procedure to return the entire table using out mode, we have to use the ref cursor. And practically, what is the use of this ref cursor within the industry? Like we are working with Java, suppose we are working with the .NET. Naturally, we need to write the stored procedure in Oracle and all. And we need to call the stored procedure from the Java or from the .NET. For that particular thing, what we need to do in the stored procedure, we need to define the select statement. And for that purpose, always we need to use the, need to declare the ref cursor over there. It might be its strong ref cursor or its weak ref cursor. Or one important thing is also there that we need to remember, it's sys underscore ref cursor. So this is all about the ref cursor. This particular notes, like the notes on the ref cursor, will be available on this particular website also. This is my blogging website. You can just go for this, santoshsi.blogspot.com. In this particular website, you will get the link for these notes. I'm just going to show you. The entire content of my YouTube videos and all, you can get the access from this blog blog websites. At present, I'm just going to post this video as well as I'm just going to post this entire content on this blog website. So what you can do, you can learn from the video and just you can copy the code from the this particular blogspot.com, santoshsi.blogspot.com website, you can get it. So thanks a lot. Yeah, lot of things are there, you can get the access from this. So thanks a lot, enjoy the day. And your feedback, your any comments, your good suggestions or even your bad suggestions, that will be good for me. Just subscribe the channel, like the channel, give some comments. Thanks a lot.